The validation controls are used to validate user input. First out, we have the required field validator, which makes an input control mandatory. By adding it from the toolbar, we can see that we get three properties filled out for us. To get it working though, we also need to select which control will be validated using the control to validate property. This field is required for all validation controls. We'll also change the error message to something more fitting. If we now run the application and try to submit with an empty text box, the validation will fail and the error message will be displayed. Note that the validation is first performed on the client side and then on the server side. The server side validation is needed in case the client doesn't support scripting or have it disabled, and it may also be stricter than the client side validation. However, even if the server side validation fails, the submit event handler will still get executed. Because of this, we must always check if the submitted page is valid before we do anything else, using the page is valid property. The next control is the range validator, which makes sure that the user input is within a specified range. For this control, we also need to set the minimum and maximum values, as well as the type field, to select if we want to validate numbers, strings, or dates. The third validation control is the regular expression validator, which checks a string against the regular expression. It uses the validation expression property to set the pattern that the string must match. The pattern here, for example, requires a 5-digit number. Fourth, we have the compare validator that compares the values of two controls. The second control is selected with the control to compare property. We then choose what relational operator to use, as well as set the type field to compare either integers, dates, or strings. If none of these four validators can help us, there's the custom validator, which allows us to write our own validation code. The client validation function property selects a client-side validation function, and the onServer validate property selects a server-side validation function. To demonstrate, here's an example. The client-side validation is performed by a JavaScript function which will validate if the value is even. The server-side validation is a C# function with the same functionality, but it will also make sure that the value is a number. Lastly, we have the validation summary control, which is used to display a summary of all validation errors on the web page in a single location. The control will base its summary on the error message properties, so to prevent the validation controls from showing the same string, we can override these error messages using the text property.